If your embroidery is too large for your available hoops, you can use Embroidery Studio's hooping mode to split it into multiple hoopings. These can be stitched consecutively to form the entire design. Each hooping can be transferred to machine folder or saved as a machine file. In this video, we take a French linen kitchen towel project and stitch it out in two hoopings. Having printed out the worksheet, we can visualize the design on our tea towel. First, mark the center of the whole design. Here we place it 10 centimeters from the base of the tea towel. Now we can mark the center of the first hooping. Here it's offset 7 centimeters from the center of the design. Now we take the sticky backing required to stabilize the stitch out. Place it in the hoop with the backside facing up. We peel it off later. Press the hoop center into position, making sure the backing is smooth and even. Using a sharp implement, penetrate the paper and peel it away from the backing. Be careful not to penetrate the backing. Tear off the excess as close as possible to the hoop rim. Now, using the positioning template, locate the center of the first hooping. Place the template center directly over the hooping center. Pressing firmly, ease the fabric into the hooping, making sure it doesn't shift under the template. Run your hand over the fabric to smooth it onto the backing. We want to avoid any potential registration problems. To prevent the fabric being caught under the machine, flip the hoop by 180 degrees. At the same time, flip the design on the machine by 180 degrees. Now start the machine. At the end of the first hooping, two registration marks are stitched out. These are needed to align the second hooping. Now we can remove the fabric from the backing. Rather than remove the backing altogether, peel off the stitch out only. We can save time and cost by simply cutting another smaller piece to cover the hole left by the first stitch out. At this point, we're going to stitch out a second set of registration marks on the backing itself. Set a reserve stop on the machine to give you a chance to position the fabric after registration marks have been stitched out. Now stitch out the second set of registration marks directly onto the backing. Remove the hoop from the machine and use a pin to align the first set of registration marks. Push the pin through the center of the registration mark to align it with the one in the second hooping. Do the same for the second set of registration marks. Again, use a pin or, with experience, use your eye. Fold the fabric back to see where the crosses meet. Again, run your hand over the fabric, making sure it sticks firmly to the backing. Use the pin again to check that the registration marks are aligned. We're now ready to put the hoop back on the machine. Once the hoop is securely in position, start the machine for the second stitch out. Once that's complete, we can again remove the stitch out from the backing. Peel away any excess from the fabric. Use an unpicker to remove the registration marks. A steam iron will flatten those marks. And there you have it, a perfectly aligned and centered two-hoop stitch out. For more information about multi-hooping in Embroidery Studio, refer to the latest online help or reference manual. See the links below. Thanks for watching.